baby, yeah, like you know. Come to the spot with a vibe, you know. Ooh, baby, yeah, like you know. Come to the spot with a vibe, you know.
Hey, Daniel here to talk about how to remove room noise in SpectraLayers. The example I have is a recording by Femi J for the song Mood that has already been processed with compressors, EQs and more, but it is evident that high frequency room noise can be heard. Let's play that back.
Baby, yeah, like you know. Come to the spot with a vibe, you know. Ooh.
To get professional sounding vocals from home recordings such as this, require that the vocal is as dry as possible prior to effects processing. We can achieve this in SpectraLayers using the AI algorithms in the reverb reduction process. And instead of using ARA mode, I'm going to drag the snippet into a separate SpectraLayers instance. The reason why will become apparent shortly. We'll have a quick listen to the raw vocal.
Baby, yeah, like you know. Come to the spot with a vibe, you know. Ooh.
It's clear that the current effects chain I have is adding air and shine to the vocal, which is also exposing the room sound as well, which we don't want. We'll go to process and reverb reduction, and it's important to note that the reverb reduction process does not depend on the FFT size as of SpectraLayers 10. The settings are simple. With type, it's simply the type of audio content to reduce reverb from. Voice or other, voice is fine, and the reduction ratio is simply the ratio of attenuation in percentages, and we have the choice of either reducing the reverb or reducing the signal. And based on the signal to noise ratio of the vocal that we've heard, I'm going to use a preset and go with voice light. I'll apply, I'll close the window, and I'll play back the audio.
Baby, yeah, like you know, come to the spot with a vibe, you know.
There is a clear difference with the room noise being attenuated, but the caveat is you don't automatically get the removed signal as a separate layer to investigate further. So let me simply undo that process. We can still obtain this and achieve a perfect decomposition by doing the following. And to note that this isn't possible to do in this way when running SpectraLayers in ARA mode. So I am going to duplicate the original into two separate layers. I'll rename them A and B. I will perform reverb reduction on layer A. So with that highlighted, go to process, reverb reduction. I'll hit apply with the same settings. I'll close the window and I'm going to duplicate this layer. I'll call it layer C. Next, I will phase invert layer C and move it below layer B. And I'll merge layer C into layer B by right-clicking on layer C and selecting merge up. Layer A remains the process sound with reverb reduction, while layer B is now the room noise that was removed. So let's listen to A then B.
Baby, yeah, like you know. Come to the spot with a vibe, you know. Ooh. Baby, yeah, like you know. Come to the spot with a vibe, you know.
So clicking the phase invert button on the original untouched layer should result in a perfect null. So if I play that back, we hear silence. I'll click the phase invert button again. I will drag layer A back into Cubase. So let's hear the original followed by the processed.
Baby, yeah, like you know. Come to the spot with a vibe, you know. Ooh, baby, yeah, like you know. Come to the spot with a vibe, you know. Ooh.
So there you have it, removing room noise using the AI algorithms within the reverb reduction process has made this vocal drier without obvious artifacts. Like, share, and subscribe if this has been helpful. Take care.